welcome back to my channel. It's Ashley here, and if you are new, hey girl, hey. Today I'm going to be sharing 6 ways that you can transform any mirror. So let's get started with transformation number 1. All right, so we're going to start with the first 2 ways that you can transform a mirror. So right now what I'm doing is I am just painting my mirror frame. So I'm going to do both of these mirrors white, and I am actually just painting this with the mirror attached to it, but you can definitely, of course, which will make it easier, to detach your mirror from the actual frame, so you don't have to worry about paint being on your mirror that you have to remove. And here I'm just removing it with one of the little razors that you can get from the Dollar Tree. Okay, so now I'm going to remove the back, remove my mirror, and work on the frame part. So for this frame, I'm just going to be using my clear wax. I'm gonna do a coat of the clear wax, and then I'm going to add my brown glaze on top of that to give this an aged kind of feel. Now we're gonna start to stencil, which is the first way that you can transform a mirror. So I'm gonna be using these Martha Stewart self-adhesive stencils, which you can pick up from Michaels. And I am going to start to stencil from the top to the bottom. Now when you're choosing your stencils, of course you can choose whatever design you want, and you can choose it to be small, you can choose them to be medium size, or you can choose the larger stencils, and you just add that to your mirror. And this is a really cool way to quickly change the look of your mirror. You can do the full mirror, you can do half the mirror, you can do a part of the mirror on the side, like whatever you want to do, just have fun with it. So the second way that you can transform a mirror is just getting some good old chalkboard spray paint and spray painting the mirror and changing it into a chalkboard. After the mirrors are complete, of course, all you're gonna do is add your mirror back onto the frame, making sure it is secure. And if you do the chalkboard one, you just wanna make sure that you season your chalkboard before you actually use it. And to do that, all you have to do is literally just take some chalk and scribble, scribble, scribble all on your chalkboard, wipe it off, and then you're good to go. All right, so this is what the mirrors look like before, of course. They're pretty dated. They look like they are still chilling in the 70s, and we just totally transformed both of them. So I love how the stencil mirror turned out. It's very unique. And again, like I said, you can use small stencils, large stencils, or you can use medium-sized stencils to transform a mirror that you might already have or that you have thrifted. Or you can go the very easy route. Literally, it's the most easiest thing that you can do to a mirror, which is taking your chalkboard spray paint and spray painting it and turning it into a chalkboard, and no one would ever know that it was a mirror previously. The second way to transform a mirror is to antique that mirror. So that is what we're gonna do with this one. So I am just removing the back, removing the mirror, and we're gonna start to work on the mirror portion. So I'm just gonna take my Citrus strip, and I am going to generously apply that to the back, let it sit for a while, and then I'm going to take my putty knife and I'm going to remove the gray back. So removing this gray backing is going to uncover the reflective surface of the mirror. And once I've uncovered that, I'm just going to take my glass cleaner and I am going to clean the surface off. And now we're gonna start the antiquing process of the mirror. So I'm just going to take some Clorox and I'm gonna start to add this to my edges of the mirror. And what the Clorox is gonna do is it's going to start to remove that reflective surface, and you're gonna start to see black like dots. So you can apply this all around your edges. You can spritz it out a little bit like I'm doing in the middle. And then you can let it sit for not that long. I think I let this sit for about 2 minutes. And then I'm going to take some of my paper towels. I was gonna say tissue paper. My paper towel, and I'm gonna start to blot my Clorox away and wipe that off. So now I'm just doing a little close up of the little black dots that I'm talking about. So you're gonna start to see those, and then you're gonna start to kind of see through the mirror. So if you want a more antiqued look, all you have to do is just keep piling on that Clorox and letting it sit and remove what you don't want from your mirror. I'm also gonna show you how this looks if you have this up in the light, so you can see where the reflective surface is removed and you can see through the mirror now. And to cover that up, I'm just gonna be using some gold spray paint and this metallic paint from Waverly, and I'm going to add those to the areas where the reflective surface is removed. So I'm using the gold. You can use whatever color you want, but I'm just, the gold gives it that more like antique kind of vibe. And then after I have added this around my mirror where I want it to be, I'm now going to take my black spray paint and I'm going to spray paint the back. And this is basically, it's technically like sealing it, but it's also going to enhance where I replace the gold and metallic color so that you'll be able to see it more on the mirror. So for my frame, I just painted it white, and then I'm adding some dark wax to it and removing it. And then after that, I'm just going to place my mirror back in and the back. And then I'm going to take that metallic color that I used for covering the reflective surface of the mirror, and I'm just adding that little detail along this mirror as well. And that is it. Literally, you can do this to whatever mirror you want. It's a really simple way to transform a mirror. And if you like that antique style, this would be perfect. And you can place this anywhere in your home. So moving along to the fourth way to transform a mirror, we are really literally gonna be planking this one. So first things first, if you have any imperfections, you wanna clean those up. So that's what I'm doing here. Added some Bondo, sanding that down. Now I'm gonna start to measure out my frame. And then I'm going to take that to my barn wood that I picked up from Hobby Lobby, and I'm going to mark where I need to cut. Then I'm going to take this to my miter saw, and I'm going to cut out all the wood that I need. And after I did that, I'm going to start to work on the frame. So for the frame, all I did was I painted this white, and then I took my clear wax, added the clear wax, and then I added the glaze. But before I added the glaze, I'm just kind of distressing the sides lightly. And then I'm gonna go in with the dark glaze and do that same thing that I did to the previous frame. And I'm just going to add that around the frame to give it some more character. So when planking this, I actually had some space at the top and the bottom. So now I'm just measuring that out, and I'm cutting off the pieces that I need to add to the top and the bottom. And then I'm going to add all of this wood with wood screws. And I'm just going to drill those holes on the side and add my screws to secure the wood in place. And that is all you have to do for this transformation for any mirror frame. Literally, this is my favorite one because I just love how this wood looks in the frame. And you could do this to any frame, and it will, of course, look amazing. All right, so moving along to the fifth way to transform a mirror, literally it is just spray painting the mirror. Spray painting can go a long way. So I am going to remove this from the frame, take the mirror out, and now I'm going to work on this frame using my sander. I'm just sanding down the paint that was previously on here. Instead of just removing it, I'm just sanding it down really, really smooth. And then I am going to putty up any little imperfections that are on the frame. So there was only one on the side, so I just putty that up real quick and sanded that smooth. And then now I'm just going to take this metallic finish that I got from Walmart, and I am going to spray my frame. And I did two coats to this frame. Now I'm gonna work on the mirror itself because it was super nasty. So I'm just taking my window cleaner and I am cleaning that off and removing, it had some paint splatters on there, so removing that. And then I'm adding it back onto my frame, and that is all that you have to do for this transformation of a mirror frame. I love how this turned out. Super simple to do, and what a nice little transformation of the mirror. So the sixth way to transform your mirror is adding slats to them. So the first thing I'm gonna do with these, of course, is I am going to clean them off. So I am using my glass cleaner and I am cleaning off my glass. So depending on your mirror, if you have things that you wanna remove from your mirror, go ahead and do that. So I'm just removing these little decorative pieces from the top, and then I am going to putty up the holes using my Bondo, and then I'm going to sand it smooth with my palm sander. The next step I'm gonna do, of course, is paint my frame. So I am using the color Old Ochre from Annie Salone. Obviously, I just love creams and whites because all the frames that I have done are that color. But anyways, the next thing I'm gonna do after I have painted the frame, I'm gonna be adding these plywood slats. So I picked these up from Joann's, and I am just putting them in a crisscross pattern. And you can put these any way that you want on whatever mirror you are using. And now after that, I am just going to kind of distress my edges with some sandpaper to give it a little bit more character. I've already stained the slats a dark walnut color, and now I'm just going to whitewash them a little bit with the Annie Salone paint color that I'm using, and also just some white chalk paint. To attach the slats to the frame, I am going to flip it over, and I'm going to remove some of the staples from the back to loosen it from my frame. And then I'm going to add my slats into the frame. And if you need to use a ruler to make sure that your measurements are correct, it's gonna be even from the top to the bottom, you can. And you can also use glue if you need to as well to attach your slats. Now all I'm gonna do is I'm just going to staple where I removed the previous staples. So this is another transformation that I love. It's just a very simple way to update or upgrade a mirror that you might have. Just go ahead and pick you up some plywood slats and you can do whatever design that you want on whatever mirror that you choose. And it will completely change the look, and your mirror will be ready to hang up wherever you would love it to be in your home. All right, so those are the 6 possible ways that you could transform a mirror that you might already own or that you want to go and pick up from the thrift store now. So I hope this video inspired you to not just throw away your mirror, but actually transform it into something different. If you enjoyed this video, make sure you give it a big thumbs up and make sure you comment down below to let me know what you think and which one was your favorite. And if you're not subscribed to my channel, make sure you click on that subscribe button and I will see you in my next one.